The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
How are you today? I am Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Welcome back to my channel. And as you know, we make videos about health and healthcare topics. And today we are going to talk about anal fissures. Very common problem. A lot of you have asked me about this. And that's why I'm making a video on this topic. Make sure to watch the complete video and do give me a feedback. How did you like the video? And share this video if you do like it. So let's start with anal fissures. What are they and why can you, how can you treat this problem? See, an anal fissure is basically a small split or a tear near the thin moist tissue, the mucosa, which is the lining of the lower rectum, the basic anal region, right? In that area there is a little split or a little tear, right? This split or tear is called a fissure, right? So what causes this fissure? This is absolutely very, very common, and it's very common in infants in very early age also. Because of that, you might see a little bit of bleeding also for them. But this can occur in any age, in absolutely any age. And in adults, the tissues, the fissures can even be caused by passing a hard stool. Sometimes you know what I'm talking about, a large hard stool which is very difficult to push out, and you actually end up getting these fissures, right? Or sometimes you might have this problem by having diarrhea for a long time, because of which the tissues become dehydrated, harden and crack, right? Then other reason can be because of decreased blood flow to that area, which again causes dehydrated tissues, and even lack of blood supply can lead to cracks. And then other reason can be too much tension in the sphincter muscles that control the anus. And one more reason is anal sex, that can also lead to these kind of fissures, right? So too much tension in the sphincter muscles can also lead to anal fissures. See, this basic condition commonly affects men, males and females equally. So it's equally affects male and females, and anal fissures are also common in females. After childbirth, after delivery, it's very common, and it's common in people with who have Crohn's disease. So all these are common things. Now we are talking about anal fissure. What happens when you do have an anal fissure? What will be your symptom? See, this is a crack in the anal skin, and when this area is stretched slightly, you will have pain. It can also be seen when you actually stretch that area slightly. And the fissure is almost always in the middle, right? And this anal fissure can cause painful bowel movement. It will cause pain when you are passing your stools, and it can even cause bleeding, fresh bleed. It's important. There may be blood on the outside of the stool or on the toilet paper when you wipe through, or the baby wipe, whatever you use, right, after the bowel movements, right? So this is classical. When it comes outside the stools or in the toilet paper. Symptoms can actually begin very slowly or even sometimes suddenly. So these are the symptoms. So what can you do? How can you test this thing? Obviously, your doctor will do a rectal examination. Look from below. Look for anal fissures by doing a little opening. And if needed, the fissures can be seen how deep they are inside your anal cavity. We can do an anoscopy there, where we actually examine the anus, anal canal or lower rectum. Sigmoidoscopy can be done. This is just to examine the lower part of intestine, whether your bleeding is because of anal fissure or because of hemorrhoids or piles. Then sometimes biopsy can also be done of the anal tissue for examination, if we think that there is something fishy going on there or something else is there, some mass is there or something, then colonoscopy can also be done if we think that you have something like Crohn's disease. And then biopsy can be taken from the colon. So a lot of tests can be done, but the basic test, simplest test of looking into the erectile area can give a good idea whether you have an anal fissure or a hemorrhoid problem. And treatment, remember, most fissures heal on their own and do not need any treatment. Most of the times, fissures do not need any treatment. Now, to prevent or treat these anal fissures in case of children, in case of infants, be sure to change their diapers very often and clean the area gently, very gently. Don't press, compress, or don't be very hard with them, right? And then if you're worrying about pain during the bowel movement, that can actually cause the person to avoid the bowel movement, and thereby it can actually cause the stools, the feces, to become more harder, which will eventually make the anal fissures worse. So don't avoid bowel movement. What you can do is you can prevent hard stools and constipation, prevent and treat constipation or hard stool by doing some dietary changes. Number one change, eat a lot of fiber or bulk, such as fruits, vegetables and grains. Then drink a lot of water. Water and fiber itself can cause stool softening, and you can actually use some stool softeners like lactulose or other kind of medicines are available in the market. Then you can ask your doctor for any ointments or creams which are available to be applied in the area. For number one thing is a numbing cream, a local anesthetic. If pain is actually interfering with the normal bowel movement, then you can apply the numbing cream, the local anesthetic cream, just 10-15 minutes before you go for a motion, and it will be easy for you to pass the motion. You can even apply some petroleum jelly around the area just to smoothen the pathway. Zinc oxide, 1% hydrocortisone cream, or a preparation of hydrogen and other products are also used to treat these kind of area. There are creams available for this purpose. Then one important thing which you need to do are sitz bath. Sitz bath is basically a warm water bath which is used for healing or cleansing, where you basically sit into a warm water tub without any clothes and you sit at least 2 to 3 times a day for 10-15-20 minutes, right? Water should only cover the hips and the buttocks. That's it. You don't have to get submerged inside. And if the anal fissure do not go away with these kind of home remedies, home care, then after a certain period of months or time, you can go for basic other medical treatments like injections, like Botox injections into the muscles of the anus or anal sphincter, so that your sphincter relaxes and you might not have any, these kind of issues. Then minor surgeries can also be done to relax the anal muscles, right? So that your sphincters, so that your fissures can be healed or they don't crack further. Prescription creams are also available, like nitrates cream, calcium channel blockers, that can be applied over the fissures to help relax the muscles. See, basic thing is there. It's a crack. It will heal. But you have to pass stools also on a daily basis, right? So you have to use these methods to let it heal. But don't worry, the prognosis is very good. Most often the anal fissures heal very quickly without any problems, and many of us do have anal fissures, we don't even notice it, right? People who develop anal fissures more are more likely to have them again and again in fissure because of constipation or some or the other problem, Remember, this is a treatable thing. All you need is a little understanding of the concept. Hope I made a few points clear. If you have any doubts, write them down below. Ask me in the live or any way you feel suitable. And give me a big thumbs up and share this video as much as you can. Remember, anal fissure, anorectal fissure, anal ulcer, anal fistula in ano, all are same thing. And this is the information about it. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Dr. Paramjeet. You are watching Dr. Education. Stay connected. Stay healthy.